Hi, I'm Anna. I'm a search specialist at Koozai. This video was suggested by Lauren at SEOmoz and is going to cover the topic of monitoring your brand in Google Analytics. There's three areas to cover here. We're going to look at traffic sources, on-site activity, and then how to use this data. The first thing I'm going to start with is keywords. It's one of the most common things looked at by SEOs in Google Analytics. And basically, it shows you all the keywords that people are using to come to your site. So what you want to do is use the filter option at the bottom of this report to get simple information about different breakdowns of keywords. And then if you need more combinations than that and you want to add extra things in, then move on to the advanced segments functionality. Set up your own custom segment and include all the variations of your brand that you'd like to track within one section. And obviously set whether you want that to be organic or PPC or both. And then what I'd recommend doing is also doing an opposite advanced segment to that so that you can then track your brand keywords versus your non-brand keywords. Then what you can do is you can track the interaction with your site from paid search and organic search to see how brand versus non-brand vary across the site. Really useful with advanced segments because you can apply that to anything. The next thing to look at is referring sites. This is harder to verify whether they're brand or non-brand related. So what you'll do is, when you have a look at it, you'll know which ones you've submitted, whether you've created that listing in Yelp, or whether that mention on the forum was somebody talking about one of your products rather than your brand. So referring sites is a bit harder, but what I'd recommend is basically, if you are setting anything up, try and make sure you can track it yourself. Which brings us on to tracking your campaign. So the way I'd recommend to do this is AdWords obviously does it itself, and you don't want to mess with that. But any other method, whether it's Bing PPC, whether it's a Facebook ad, whether it's a job ad on Gumtree, you want to use your campaign tracking URL where you can. Now this is a tool from Google. It's a URL builder basically. And you can put in your campaign terms, source, medium, that sort of information. And that then provides Google Analytics with a specific information about that link. And that enables you to have a lot more functionality. You can obviously split test brand things that are going out on the web, see which ones work best. And then the extra special way to do this is to use the URL tool builder for your campaign tracking with a QR code. So you can use this offline in any sort of media advertising. You can put it on a bus stop, you can put it in a magazine. Basically, you create the URL, you add your tracking to it, and then you build the QR code from that, and then you use that in your media. And that allows you to track both offline and online brand mentions, brand promotions, whatever it is, you can track it now. So yeah, really useful piece of modern technology. Just a small little barcode, it's readable by most new smartphones. Anything with a self-focusing, auto-focusing camera can read it. So yeah, really up-and-coming piece of technology that's really good and you can track it. So bring that into Google Analytics and you'll be laughing. Next, we're going to look at on-site activity. You've got your users to the site, so now what do they do? What you're probably going to want to do is sort of divide up your site into sections. Which ones are brand-related pages and which ones aren't. And then you want to see sort of how many page views there are per area. And then compare these. You can see maybe whether brand pages account for 10% of the page views of your whole website in a month, that sort of thing. So use the page views data, use the little filter box at the bottom in the content drill down report, and you can start to see where things are going with your website and how each section is visited across the site in comparison to other sections. I'd recommend to start with just play around, put the data into Excel, draw yourself a pretty little graph. You can see it really nice and easily, and track it over the months. And that way you can see whether, for example, activity on your brand pages might suddenly increase in 1 month when you're launching an advertising campaign. It's really good to see how that sort of works alongside your other pages. So there's also a nice... more tidy way to do this, really, less manual. Basically, use custom variables, and you can label each page really with what it actually is. So you can label all your brand pages with brand terms. Just categorize them that way using custom variables. And then you see this information separately in Google Analytics, and it's really useful. You can create advanced segments with your custom variable, so you can see, you can apply that segment to anything. So you'll label your About Us pages as one thing, your product pages as another, you know, work out which ones are brand related and which ones aren't, and then you can really see how people interact with those pages much more easily, really, within Google Analytics. So the next way of seeing data more easily is to set up a specific filter within its own profile. So you set up a new profile in Analytics within the same account, and then add the filter. You can choose whether you want to segment and only see data from organic or certain keywords, maybe. You can also set it to do things like only track visits to a certain area of your site. That's going to be really useful if you've got core brand pages that you want to see just the activity on those. Whether everybody coming to those pages is coming from an internal click, or whether they're coming externally to those pages. It's really nice and easy to see all the information in one little place. The other thing that you might want to consider when you've got a brand is that it might have other websites. If you've got two websites and your users are flitting around between the two the whole time, you might want to think about cross-domain tracking. So this basically involves an extra line or two of code and then an extra bit of code between the links. And this then passes on the cookie information between the domains. And you can see the referral information for the first site present on the information for the conversion on the second site, for example. It's just one of those common things where brands, especially big brands, have more than one domain name and want to see how things go around. So the next thing to do is to use your data. So how are we going to do that? We've got a couple of options here. Custom reports are really useful for giving you exactly what you want and putting it in a presentable form that you can easily just send to somebody. So if you've got a board of directors who want to see certain information, they don't ever want to use Google Analytics themselves, you can basically just set up your custom report to show exactly what you want it to show. Apply an advanced segment, and that way you can show that information for that segment of traffic, for example. Do a custom report on your landing pages that are related to your brand, and apply your advanced segment to show only a brand-related keyword visits. And then you've got exactly the information you're looking for. And maybe do a comparison of those pages' interaction compared to non-brand keywords. So custom reports you can really play around with, and then obviously use your advanced segments. Don't forget them. And then the next thing to do, custom alerts. These are really useful, not just for brand monitoring, but for just monitoring your website in general. What it enables you to do is get an email when things change. So for example, if your brand-related keywords, that segment that we've already set up, if that suddenly sees an increase of 50% overnight in visitors, you wouldn't have a clue unless you actually logged in and looked. So you set up a custom alert, tell it to give you an email, and then on your inbox, first thing Monday morning, you know that over the weekend something happened, you can see exactly what it was. It just alerts you to when things are going on, and it's really useful for monitoring your brand. There's obviously things you can do with your custom alerts. You can create them for any sort of dimension or metric, whether it's landing pages, page views, custom variables, and then obviously use your advanced segments. You're going to get bored of me saying that, but they're very good. The last point is the API. Now this, like custom reports, it's just cooler again. So you can create your own dashboard, your own spreadsheet, your own report basically. It can be set to update automatically when you open it with the latest data or whatever data you choose, and just show you exactly what you want. You build it, you brand it, you just use the API to pull in the data, show you the statistics. And then this is really useful for sending to people or just using as a reporting tool. However you want to use it, it just saves you having to faff around in Analytics. You just build it once, you got it. And then you can use the same template for another client or another brand or another area of the site or a different advanced segment. So lots of different things to do, whether you're using it or just gathering it or just applying an advanced segment to everything. There's plenty more information on our blog all about these sorts of things. And also we're doing some more videos on this. Sam in particular is doing a video on protecting your brand online. So check that out. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel to have a look at that. And also check out our website. It's got loads more stuff. And thanks for watching, really.